We're learning more about fines levied by the city on waste collection companies that have failed to pick up trash and yard waste on time. I-Team investigator Jennifer Waugh breaks down the numbers and shows us which sides of town have had the largest number of complaints in the past 2 months.
The city pays three companies to pick up your trash, recycling, and yard waste. Each covers a certain part of the county. Now we have learned that two of those haulers have been so slow in doing what you pay for in taxes that they have been fined tens of thousands of dollars. Waste Pro has been charged more than $116,000 since July for its delays. It serves the southeast portion of the county. And the hauler in charge of the west side, Advanced Disposal Services, has been fined more than $62,000. The I-Team is digging deeper into what's being done to fix the delays. Because many of you tell us you are fed up paying for a service you're not getting on time.
That pile's been sitting there at least 6 weeks.
Eddie Coulier lives on Proxima Road, where pile after pile after pile of yard waste has been sitting in his west side neighborhood so long it's dead.
A delay is a week, 10 days. When it's 2 months, almost 3 months, that's not delay. That's just ignoring the problem. I texted the city, I texted waste management, and then I texted my city councilman, and then I texted the I-Team, and I never heard back from anybody but you guys.
The only reason the pile in front of his house isn't overflowing?
You drive it all the way to Clay County.
Green Cove Springs.
He's been paying and, to dump it.
How long has this been sitting here?
About 3 weeks. Been here. My yard man did my yard, and he put it out there. And he also told me when he put it there that they hadn't been picking it up.
Fanny Tensley lives on London Bridge Road, also on the west side.
Does it frustrate you that you're paying for this service and it's not being completed?
Of course. Yes, it does frustrate you when you have it in front of your door. Yeah, it needs to be gone. And the neighbors and up and down the street been here longer than mine have.
We've received the same complaint along Herta Road. And here along Transylvania Avenue, this looks like it's been here for a while. We know that one, it's been at least 3 weeks, and there's one there too. And a similar problem here on Sizemore Court. And again here on Shorecrest Drive. With each turn down a road, we find at least two or three piles waiting to be collected. Whose shoulders does this ultimately fall on to solve this problem?
It is the administration. It's under the mayor.
Councilwoman Randy DeFore represents part of the West Side where we've received the most complaints.
Has the council, you or anyone else that you're familiar with on the council, gone to the mayor's office and said, hey, what's being done?
Daily. Daily.
DeFore is frustrated too. She says she gets the same excuse about the vendors the city has hired for waste collection.
It's just a staffing issue and they can't find quality people to do the work.
Eddie Coulier says that should not be an excuse anymore.
I don't understand why they have to sit here and wait 3 months and let to try get the contractors to catch up with what they can't even keep up with to begin with. I work contracting all my life, and I can tell you if I got behind, I brought in help.
My requests for an interview with the director of public works and the mayor were both turned down, by the way, but the mayor's office says it has brought in help to alleviate staffing shortages among the haulers. A spokesperson says that city trash collectors are now working 7 days a week and other city workers are pitching in as well to help. And we have learned that yard waste delays are by far the number one complaint. More than 8,300 were made to the city in July and more than 9,000 were made last month. Now, the city says that yard waste takes up more room in the truck, requiring more frequent runs, which is why trash and recycling is often picked up first, but not yard waste. Jennifer Waugh, Channel 4, the local station.
Jen, thank you. The mayor's office says the fastest way to file a complaint is to use the MyJax app or go to myjax.custhelp.com. You can call 630-CITY-2, but you may have to wait for your call to be answered.